Everyone, today we will see another interesting topic in data analysis. So it's like a beautiful plotlet charts. So plotlet is another what is that module, you can say package or a Python library like for creating beautiful charts like matplotlib, what we already used. So what we will be doing is we will be using Android App Store data, which is actually downloaded from Kaggle. So if I just go here, this is the link, but it is very old, someone has created. So we will be using this our data. It was created in 2018. So let's take this data and we'll be doing the analysis and we will be creating the charts on top of it. So now here what we will be making by end of this session, both part one and part two. So if you see here, so generally if you have gone interested where you can build your own iOS app or Android app, how things app works in app stores, how we get revenue depending on downloads, or how it will be taking. So this is actually this is a very big business, like apps. So because everyone, as of now, everything is on mobile, so there is a lot of demand for Android apps or iOS apps. So so this is again depending on the revenue model and depending on how you give our app. So depending on that, how many downloads your app having, depending on that, revenue will be generated. So what we will be doing today using the data sheet. So we will be doing this, what are the different type app categories are there, and which app category compelling, popularity, and how many downloads, and we will be checking what paid versus free, how many downloads are there, generally how much we charge for a paid app. So which apps are the highest revenue, and how many paid apps will pick up the development cost depending on the source revenue. So so all this data we will be analyzing, and how all these questions will be answered. So before that, what we will be doing from technical perspective, so we will see how to remove duplicates from a data set, pandas data set. So we will be using pandas along with plotlet. So unwanted symbols or unwanted data into numeric format, and how to wrangle data, how to drop columns, and how to compelling visualizations. So pie chart, donut charts, or vertical, horizontal, or grouped bar charts. And we can use actually color scales in the plotlet. And plotlet graphs are very user friendly. Actually, we will be seeing that. If you see the plotlet, matplotlib versus plotlet, it is interactive. The plotlet graphs are interactive, so whenever you click on the graph and you want to just check what is the data only on that particular bar or particular stack, you can just click on that and it will just show only that. So it is very interactive, automatically it changes. So we will be seeing that later. So as usual, we have provided the starting file, zip file. So once you download it, upload it to Google Drive and open it as a Google Collaborator notebook, and the same thing, add a zip file to our thing. So what we did, so just drag and drop app.csv to here. If I just go back, so here. So before we used to give everything, right, how to see that, and we have provided screenshots. So as of now, we are not providing any screenshots for preliminary data. Just we will be seeing
how we answer all these columns.
And I think this everything we know, like dot columns, that had top five rows. So, but this is actually a different thing. So if you want to check only five different samples, like not top or bottom, so it's like randomly selecting any five rows, then we'll be using this sample method. And we will be checking all this, like we have to remove all the last updated column and Android version column from the data frame. And how many rows have not a number NaN values in the rating column, and we will be removing that. So, and are there any duplicates also? We will be checking duplicates. So how many entries for Instagram app? So we will be checking that and how to remove that, so that our app, our data frame remains clean. So this is the first step we need to do for any starting of any analysis. We will be removing all the unnecessary data. So it's called data cleaning. So let's go. So now, as usual, we have to import a pandas. So the plotl express, the second is the plotl.express as px. So we are importing plotl express as px. So this is just to display this again, we will be showing. So, but to display all the numbers in a float format, for example, in this 0.25, like a decimal format. So up to how many digits? So it's like up to 2 digits. So we'll be using this. So it automatically format what are the numbers in the decimal format. If it is very high, like after decimal, if there are 10 digits, it will format to 2 digits. So yeah. So now just we are reading app.csv. So now we will be seeing how many columns are there, like rows and columns. So if you see, we have 10,841 rows and 12 columns are there. Now we will be checking the sample data. So yeah. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 columns. So this is app category, rating, reviews. And if you see, this is having a NaN rating. So if you see, before one I have run this, is, if you see the index, it is a different index. If I just rerun it again, now if you see, I am getting a different index numbers. This is the sample thing. So yeah, so we have provided this link also. Just if you do press Control and open and click on this link, it will automatically redirect to this. So yeah, so how it is sample records, it will just how many records we need to return, it's n generally. So we have provided only 5 records to return. If you want 10 records, you can give 10 records also. So there are another parameters also there. So yeah, we can just go around this. So yeah, so it depends on whatever scenario we need. So depending on different scenarios, it will be this thing. Like, so now the columns you can directly do df apps.columns also, or we already seeing directly here. If you want, I just make apps.columns. It will just display columns. Yes, So now we have to drop unused column. So this is already we have did before, like we have dropped any column. So it's a drop method we are calling on the data frame, and we are passing whatever the column names we not needed in a list, and we are saying it's the access is nothing but column. So access 0 is row and access 1 is columns. So, and we are saying we should be dropped permanently, so it should be in place equal to true. So once it is done and once we run it, so now if you see here there is no this to rating. If I just rerun this also again, you won't see the two columns what we have dropped just now. So now again, how many NAND values? Because already we have seen is NA. So now on rating, so we are using dot notation, df apps dot rating dot rating is the column name, rating, and is NA. And we are slicing the data frame depending on this condition, and it will return us another data frame. So we are just showing row start shape, and then we are seeing the head, the printing both. So yeah, now we have around 1474 columns, like rows, and 10 columns which are having an NAND value. Now we can actually directly drop NA. So if you see here, directly we can drop if you want to drop anything, because we are not considering rating. If there is no rating, we are just dropping all the rows. So yeah, you can directly just drop NA. So now if you just, now we have finally 9367 of 10 columns. So if you see here, before we used to have 10841, now it is 9367 columns. So now the same, so as of now what we have checked is NA. So similarly, there is another thing called duplicated, and to check whether they are got duplicated or not. So the same thing we have applied. So again, we have on total data frame we are checking duplicated, and we are just slicing or filtering that using this condition. We are filtering clean, and we are seeing duplicated rows data frame. Now we are having, if you just print it, we are having a shape. So there is 476 duplicates and 10 rows, and when we are just see here, it is giving add some glimpse of data. So now we have gone up to here, check duplicates, use duplicate using the use duplicated method. How many entries can you find for a use dropped to remove any duplicates from? So yeah, so we have achieved duplicated rows. Now we have to check how many duplicates are there for Instagram. So if you see here, we are just again using dot notation, we are calling app, and in the app it should equal to Instagram value, and then on that we are using this filtering condition on this data frame. Now if we just run it, it is getting, yeah, this. So but if you carefully observe, There is two rows, like 10806 and 10809, is having the same data. There is no. There is no change. So if you want to drop duplicates on entire data frame, then this is just we need to call drop duplicates method. So we are actually again after dropping duplicates, we are assigning back to this data frame, same data frame. If you don't want, you can just keep you can directly do like this, or we can just remove that and keep in place equal to true. That also works. So if I run this, or if I just run this, so now 809 is gone. So it got the duplicate row got dropped. But again, if you want to specify only a set of columns as a duplicates, for example, here if I am seeing rating is same, the size is same, install same, everything same except reviews are different, right? So I just want, I am not considering reviews is not part of my data analysis, so that I don't need, but I just want app, what is the rating and what is the price. So I am more considering about app rating and price. So if I just take this, Instagram rating is 4.5 and price is 0. So for everything, okay, I think it is type. Anyways, if it is rating or any else, like if you want some kind of columns, a set of columns to be unique, so then you can actually pass subset. So only I want these columns to be unique. So if I just see here, Instagram type free and price. If I just carefully observe, these three are actually duplicates. If I just consider only these three columns, those are duplicates. So depending on only that columns, if you want to drop duplicates, then you can actually directly use subset equal to this one and then run. Yeah, now you got because we have just see Instagram again. So here, yeah, now if I finally run shape, because we have dropped all the duplicates using the subset also, this is the final data frame we have. We have got 8199 rows and 10 columns. Now this is all what we have done, preliminary data examination. Now going here, so with apps. So which apps are the highest rated? So there is another preliminary exploration. The highest rating, most reviews, and largest size. So which apps are the highest rated, and which is having the largest size, and which is having the number of reviewers? Are there any paid apps among top 50? So let's go back. So now identify which are the have. So it's straightforward. So it's like we are just sort values depending on a rating. And we this already we have done the same thing, ascending equal to false. Once we keep, it will give the highest rating app, and we are just checking top 5. So this is, yeah, the top 5. So if you see, it's a 5 rating, and we are on for reviews, and yeah, it is completely free, installs is only one. In terms of size, if you see here, what is the highest size? Now we are taking this column, ascending equal to false, and then Yeah. So this is 700 MB size. Yeah, so depending on what other data we have, this is the highest size data we are having, the highest size app. So the same thing, we are just reviews, highest reviews, and we are just keeping at the equal 50 because we need to check if any paid app is there on top 50. So yeah. If you see, Facebook is having highest reviews, and if I just check going down, WhatsApp, Instagram, top 3 is having highest reviews, Messenger. If you check, there is no one paid app also in the top 50. So now all Android content rating, like everyone teen or mature 17 plus, let's take a look at distribution content. Yeah, so now so we will be using Plotly instead of Matplotlib now. So now what we will be doing, we will be plotting rating, content rating. So if I just go here, so there is a content rating column also. So who uses, like what is the rating, everyone everyone 10 plus, everyone 17 plus, everyone mature, Twitter. So they have categorized, so depending on that we will be plotting our data. So before that, what we will be doing, we have to get the value counts. So how many value counts for everyone, like, so how we will be doing. The ratings. Now what we will be doing, from the data frame, content rating column, and we are getting value counts, and it's we are giving ratings. So ratings we are calling, this is the variable. So here if you see, this is actually index, and this is actually count. So we are having, for everyone there is 6611. So for teen there is 912 apps. For mature, the 377 apps. For adults only, there are only 3 apps. For there is no unrated, there is only 1 app. So now how we can plot a pie chart using Plotly. So the first thing is, like, already we have imported. We have to import Plotted Express as PX we have imported. So now what we can directly, there is nothing but px.py, and we have to just pass labels and values. So labels is nothing but ratings dot index, so index is this one, and values is value. So it automatically calculates using math behind, and how much percentage. So yeah, so that's we have to show this as we already told this show. Again, it works on interactive environment like Jupyter or Google Colab, but it doesn't work on any other IDEs. So we have to explicitly call figure.show. So yeah, so if you see, it is mentioned in percentages, but when you go here, it is actually giving us the values. So here 6611 is the everyone, but we are unable to distinguish, right? Like, we can't actually see. For example, just I'm going here. So for the next thing, what what we'll be doing. Now we will be customizing our pie chart. So this is the documentation link we already provided. So if I just go here, express.py, so how to, there are multiple various parameters available. What is, so we can give custom hoverings. So let's see what exactly we will be doing. So we call update traces. So traces is nothing but again, whatever we have seeing, for example, let me go back. So for example, this is traces. So if you see here, it is directly giving me here. So, but if I just want labels to be displayed outside, and values what need to be displayed, so we are updating our traces. So graphical marks in the traces collection of attributes. So, so what we want to display also, like how to display also, it will be something like this, percentage plus label. So again, if I just go back to the code, what we are doing, labels is the same, reticular index, we are giving content rating, that's just title. Now we are giving using names parameter. So names parameter is nothing but what are the labels. So now the text position update traces, now text position is like just outside, and I want info like percentage plus a label. So if you just see here, so names, it is like the legend. I think we already used a legend in the matplotlib. Similar kind of stuff here. Yeah. If you see here, it's a very interactive. So we have a label equal to teen. Now we are getting a label and value. And it is actually displaying a text position is outside. What is the teen and text info is actually we are displaying it outside. Before it used to be inside, whatever the percentage and the label. Now we are just in text info. We are displaying both percentage and a label. Like I meant to say, this is percentage outside label under different percentage, but here we are displaying both label and so there is another, like I just want teen, how much it is there, like, or if I just don't want teen, it's automatically so I don't want teen, but I want everything else to be plotted. So depending on that, so ignoring teen data, so it automatically plot it. If I just click on it, and there is actually, we can this plot option also, like if I just want to take a snapshot of this graph, so it got downloaded. So whatever we plotted, we can actually save it as a JPEG image also. So it is directly straightforward. Just if we click on it, it automatically get downloaded. So now the same thing, if I want to plot as a, so this is the same thing what we are showing. I want to plot it as a Dow chart, for example, something like this. So how I will be plotting it? The same, but we have to just pass this one like whole, and actually we are updated traces in the if I just check, so we are just passing this we are actually creating a hole here, and we are what we are doing, we are updating traces. The text position should be inside, and text font size we are 15, and we are giving text percentage info as percentage. So we are not giving a percentage plus label, but we are just want only percentage inside the dough chart. Now if I just run here, so there is no text coming here, but if I just want a label also, if I just run it, yeah. So here this is very the unrated one is very one, so it won't visible generally. It is very minute, very minute. So yeah, because if you just keep inside, now if I just keep it outside, how it behaves, let's see. Yeah. The same way what we have seen in this. Yeah, depending on that, but in donut chart it's good that we if we keep inside the percentages. So but if you see here unrated, yeah, actually we can't able to see, so that's why plotlet graphs are very useful. So if you want to check unrated is plotted or not, yeah, and how much value it's data value is there, yeah, this is the very good way. So plotlet graphs are very interactive, like depending on our requirements. Similarly, we will be seeing tomorrow. We will be seeing different types of graphs. For example, like bar graphs. And this is a horizontal bar graph, and this is a scatter plot, yeah. And this is a bar graph using different color grades, yeah, and side by side graphs also, and this is a box plot. So yeah, we will be seeing maybe tomorrow and after tomorrow also. This is a little bit big, yeah. And everything is interactive. For example, if I just I want here, yeah, I just want okay, because this is just a marker. So if I just want this. And this is another kind of interaction. So yeah, I just want to check this plot area, how much they are personalizations, photography. Yeah. Just double click and it will go back. Yeah, I think that's it for today. We will check tomorrow.